The sexiest job over the next 10 years is going to be data scientist.
So what I do outside of data, I ride bikes, but I also love the data to do with bikes.
I love numbers, right, and I'm not going to hide from that.
I love data and I do data 24/7.
Data is our passion. Data is everyone's passion at this moment.
If you're passionate about numbers, about curious, about helping people make better decisions and really have a passion for problem solving, and I think we help bring that together in analytics.
There was a great saying that if you want to control the world, you can do it by the data.
And my future is basically to look into evidence-based consulting, something which data can only provide.
So my whole idea is to work as a data scientist. This track, this course will help me finding those sort of jobs in the coming years. Before I started, I contacted the faculty, how would be the course like, and they advised that it would be a mix of theory and prac.
This is a very rare scenario where we have the real case presented to us, and having to provide that sort of value-added reports or those insightful reports that can really drive strategy.
The key feature of this Deakin program is the industry involvement, you know, and the real-time industry involvement that's involved. So this unit is the pinnacle of that. It gives them a chance to put it in a practice in a way that is incredibly authentic. So you've got a real client, real problem, real data, and you've got a real consulting firm who are taking them end-to-end.
So if you guys have any questions, anything you want to say, anything you want to share, please share it. And please bring it to the group, bring it to the team as a whole, because with that we'll all function far better than if we sort of keep things back and are afraid to share them. Deakin, by putting together this Masters of Analytics course, have really taken a lead in equipping students with the skills they need to be able to analyse these analytics problems in a business context. Right? So right the way from the theory behind predictive analytics through to how do I present that, so the data visualization skills and all of the gamut of different skills in between. They've been putting these modules forward through this course. We're now linking those together in this capstone project where they're dealing with a real client, with a real issue. It's really going to equip the students with the skills they need in the real world to be able to solve these problems.
So the client is World Vision, so it's a household name, everybody knows what World Vision does. And we have the head of analytics for World Vision in the classroom talking to the students, engaging with the students, because she wants a real solution for World Vision to take away.
I guess over the next 9 sessions, you guys are going to have the opportunity to put your analytical skills and your creative mindsets into solving what is actually a real life business problem. And what we want to do with the case study is we want to get better at meeting the Gen Y supporter needs. So as part of that case study, we're looking at, I guess, the products and the solutions, both non-financial and financial. What are the best solutions for engaging with the Gen Y? And also for keeping them on, not just for a short space of time, but so they can actually have a long-term engaged, a journey with World Vision.
Well, initially when I actually joined this subject, I was a bit hesitant as well, in the sense that there was a lot of responsibility, I believe, being that it's a real-life case study.
That makes it more enjoyable for students because they have the opportunity to discuss the solutions with the clients, so to identify the best option for the business, and also they have the opportunity to discuss with business analytics experts from PwC, and they can get that guidance from those people that have a lot of experience in this area.
Even though it's challenging, it's pressure, you're in a learning environment, and yeah, we're enjoying it very much.
The most interesting thing is that we are just getting a feeling of the real world experience. People that we are working with them, they are very, very experienced, they are from industry, you know, it's not just from academia. So we have the academic knowledge, and now we are trying to use that academic knowledge in a real world problem.
So if I had the opportunity to complete this course, working with a real client on a real problem from start to finish, it's an opportunity that you'd jump at.
I think this is a fantastic opportunity for the students. It's something I'd have loved to have done when I was studying myself.
Since this is a group activity, different group members were all allocated to do different tasks. Chris did the initial research and found out the business drivers, and Warren agreed to put every single slide together and make a PowerPoint presentation. And my job was to do the primary data analysis and also do the data investigation, preparing data heat map and preparing the mind map.
Well, I kind of slacked off a little bit being overseas, but they are great mates, Chris especially as well. He's always been in touch with us, you know, giving us a heads up as to where it is, what the stage is. Ishtiak has led initially as well. He's our IT guy in some way, so if there's anything in terms of data or massive data or creating some sort of an IT related, more visually presentable reports, Ishtiak is the way to go.
To be frank, I really never seen any data sets like this. I've worked with big data files, but when you receive the data set from the World Vision, they are enormous sizes. When you have combined them together, the text file became 7 gig, which is massive.
And I do remember the previous lecture that we just attended, we found out that other people, other group members had the same issue with the data heat map, so there was a bit of confusion with how to go about tackling it.
I think the opportunity the students have had to work with World Vision in this project has been absolutely fantastic. It's given them insight into the fact that the world is not nice and neat and just numbers, it's about real interactions with real people.
Yeah, so myself and the team were involved every week. So we attend the session every Thursday night. So there's always at least two representatives from my team that attend. So we worked very closely with the students the whole way along, which has been great. And just watching the way that they've, I guess, learnt and developed along the way, it's been a fantastic experience.
We were very lucky as well in terms of World Vision Australia coming to our lecture to actually explain to us what exactly they need, what exactly their expectations are, and we can just focus on those reports at which that they need.
We still haven't done the data heat maps yet because we're just puzzled what should we include in the data heat maps, because there are lots of categories in it. But hopefully tonight we'll be finalizing it. What sort of segments we need to include in the data map.
After Ishtiak was able to join the tables, we were more comfortable, and we were able to get data imported off into Tableau, which is a data vision software. So, and we were quite amazed to see what we found of the visualization reports that Tableau was able to provide us. Which was great, and I think that led us to discover more about the data that was there.
Analytics as an area has exploded over the last 10 years or so with the increase in the amount of data available and the technology to make the most of it.
Business analytics is basically a combination of disciplines from computer science, information management, statistical modeling, management science that allows you to deal with massive amounts of data. So it's really a discipline that's come about from the era we live in. You know, it's the discipline of the information age.
Data is growing exponentially. One statistic is that the amount of data created since the beginning of time and 2003, every written word, every sonnet by Shakespeare, etc., is now created every 2 days, and by the year 2020 will be created every hour.
Last year, all of the data that was collected was more data than had ever been collected. So what that data provides us with is insight into customers and consumers, and it gives us an understanding as to what makes people tick. And the idea behind that is that we can then better meet their needs.
This course in particular is very much linked to taking those insights, taking those pieces of analysis and working with the client on a day-to-day basis and understanding how they can make a change in their organisation as a result of that analysis. Not just giving them a relationship, but giving them something that they can take to the business, something they can change, something they can get a benefit out of.
Another statistic sort of talks about this integration of all of these different skills, database skills, problem solving, business skills. But what I wanted to highlight here is that communication is a big part of being a data scientist. It's not about being a statistician or an actuary or a computer scientist. It's being able to bridge that and be a business person as well and communicate it to your stakeholders. And communicating accurately or efficiently with stakeholders is about speaking their language. What we're actually doing is telling stories. And you know, storytelling is as old as civilization itself, and it's about engaging people in that emotional connection. And if you're just missing what drives them emotionally, then you're never going to tell a story they're interested in. When you get up there to talk about something, know that you are showing people value that they couldn't get at. They knew their data was valuable. 10 years ago, they invested in those ERP systems. They collected all this data. You're the magician who brings it to life. Own it. Be the rock star and be the expert doctor, because when those two things come together and you engage people in analytics, you really are, you know, working totally at the sexiest job in the world.
The takeaway point for me would be, even though you are crunching the numbers, but to become a good data scientist, you have to have the communication skills. Yeah. You have to some sort of sense of what's going on around you, and you have to be knowledgeable as well. So the assignment was due. The assignment is due on Wednesday, was it?
Yeah, Wednesday
12. At 12 o'clock. 12 o'clock at noon. And the night before, I was sleeping at 4 o'clock. I couldn't finish it.
Yeah.
I had 3 hours. After 3 hours of sleep, I got up in the morning. I went to work. At work, I had to work on my assignments other than working. I was lucky on that day. It was not that busy.
Yeah.
And no one was wrong.
All right.
Yeah, finally, I've managed to submit the assignment at 10 o'clock. But I was not happy with the work that I put in.
Yeah, I think it's the same with me. I did I submitted at 10 o'clock. So yeah. What I did was I stayed back all night in office. So pretty much, it's the whole night.
And make office your home.
Absolutely. I had a couch, my CEO's couch, so I can sleep there. But I didn't get a chance to sleep anyway. So. Yeah. But yeah, again, sticking to the deadline, I think that was quite challenging, but get a different perspective, you know, this is what it is, that you need to put in time and effort, and there is a deadline means that we need to, you know, work a little bit, maybe in hindsight, slightly a bit more focus and a bit more effort. We are yet to sit down,
down and to do some mock presentation.
Mock presentation among ourselves with the slides. So. We need to collate together all our slides and see which is the best one that we come up with. Mm. Hopefully, fingers crossed, but yes, we'll work hard for sure. Yeah.
I think what's been great for us in delivering this course is to explore the problem with the students, for them to provide a fresh light on the issue for us, because we're coming from our view of the world, the students are coming from a very different angle, and some of that input's been brilliant to see.
I've really enjoyed the interactions with the students and running the subject, and watching them grow in their confidence in dealing with the clients more so. So starting off slightly apprehensive about what's going to happen next, it's a new type of course, it's something they've never had to do in the past, and watching those students grow in their interactions with the client, their ability to present, their ability to discuss the complex issues inside the problem, that's been something that I've really enjoyed watching that happen.
So we worked very closely with the students the whole way along, which has been great. And just watching the way that they've, I guess, learnt and developed along the way. Also just having exposure to new ideas on you know, for instance, I've talked about Generation Y and how we best meet their needs. So having exposure to some new ideas on how we actually might do that. And some of the students within the course are actually Gen Y themselves. So I think they're going to provide some really amazing insight into that specific generation.
If you look at Gen Y here, you can see it is 19.89% of people actually connecting with World Vision Australia. But what is more surprising is that if you look at GOT here, 62.39%, that's a whopping, that's a big amount there. So which means they are the future of Gen Y.
As it was mentioned by previous group's presentation, yes, we do have online as a popular group, but before that what we found was interesting, the direct mail as an inbound channel. And also we have retail, but you'll find that we have highlighted others as great, because others by itself doesn't mean anything to us.
So from a supporter's individual journey with World Vision, the idea would be that they would participate year on year, or would it be really a mechanism to get
the student presentations were really interesting. the diversity of what they did. You know, some did a very detailed analysis, a very in-depth analysis. Some were very creative. They came up with ingenious ideas. You know, some brought in external perspectives that were not in the data, you know. So collectively, I think the client ended up with a group of insights. It's like they had four sets of consultants working for them. So yes, I was very, very impressed. I've got to say very proud of what the students have achieved. Yeah, look, I'm absolutely delighted because it had all the twists and turns. It had reality, it had uncertainty, you know, it had a client waiting for something concrete. And I have no doubt that for the students, they got a level of authentic, you know, work experience in a way that we couldn't have given any other way. You know, it was just fantastic.
It was really exciting, very helpful, not just for me personally, but also in terms of my contribution towards World Vision as a non-profit organization trying to improve people's lives all over the world. So I'm really, I wouldn't say, well, honored in some way as well, which I'm very happy that I'm associated with this project.
To have exposure to see, I guess, what's happening with analytics from an academic perspective, and also to see the talent that's coming through, it's so exciting. When I went to uni, analytics didn't exist, so I can't wait to see what's going to come out of this course, particularly within Deakin over the next few years, and get incredibly excited by that.
By completing the Masters of Analytics, and you know, specifically the Decision Analytics and Practice module, it's really going to identify within that student's capability the fact that they have worked on real-life problems. They've taken their theoretical understanding, they've applied that across the business landscape, and they've worked with a client to try and solve an issue that they're facing now. And that sets a candidate above other people in the field who may have just a purely theoretical or purely analytical degree.
Lots of people can do analysis. What's valuable for us and for our clients is the people who can do the analysis and tell you why it's important and convert it into real actions.
I only wish this course had been around when I was at uni. You know, it's an amazing course, and I think it's really going to set these students up well for a future in analytics.
I think Deakin's certainly at the forefront in terms of embracing partnerships with industry and working with the likes of us, but also other industry partners to really give the students a top class insight into what the real world of analytics is like. I don't think the students are going to get that experience on any other course.
Hopefully in coming months or coming years, I'll be using some of the tools I'm learning. And at least if I'm not working with the tools, there's some knowledge that I've gathered here of the experience that I can use.
I was in Sydney on the weekend, and I hired a big Harley Davidson. The Harley people, who were very nice and probably pumping up my tyres a little bit, said, listen, when you came in the other day, we were actually trying to have a bet. Were you a rock star or a doctor? And I said, actually, I'm both. I'm a data scientist.
I think we have definitely created some rock stars. The confidence the students have gained through this, you know, I can see how much they've grown. So there's no doubt they are feeling like rock stars at the end of today.